It is great to see you all in person. Great news, Pablo, first of all, for Come From Away with an all-Canadian cast here at the NAC. That'll be great. We're all looking forward to that. Mais vraiment, là, ce que Pablo a dit, là, c'est tellement le fun de voir tout le monde rassemblé ici au Centre national des arts durant cet important sommet de la culture. We're all, I think, pretty pleased to be gathering in person, but Zoom was good and it had its places, and I think the fact that we're going to be able to continue to move forward in a way that has been informed by this difficult 2 years and do lots of things in person and a few things virtually will make sure that we get everything done. I have to say, I was just about an hour ago on Instagram Live, just sort of doing a virtual thing, to kick off Asian Heritage Month here in Canada with the newest addition to the Marvel Cinematic Universe from Canada, Simu Liu, who was awesome. And he's an amazingly powerful, not just actor, but writer and producer of content as well, and telling stories that span the breadth and scope of this country and beyond is what this community has always done so well, but has rarely been as important as we're all trying to come together and learn from each other and figure out the right path forward after this pandemic. We often say that culture is at the heart of who we are. To think of culture as heart is a great image because it's true on so many levels. When artists tell stories through whichever medium they choose, they bring life to every part of our country, from coast to coast to coast. They move us. They challenge us. They make us feel what they feel. Your work is at the heart of who we are, because you create shared experiences which play a fundamental role in building a stronger, more cohesive society. We have a country that is very proud of its diversity, proud of its differences, incredibly rich because of all those differences. But diversity on its own doesn't create strength. Diversity that leans in to learn from each other, to challenge itself with those differences, to share those perspectives and those experiences, to build something greater than the whole, than the sum of its parts. That's what Canada, and specifically the Canadian arts community, has been unbelievably good at over the past decades. And it's a story that needs to be celebrated both through the individual stories, but also by standing up strongly and proudly and showcasing what happens when you have a vibrant, empowered, supported, diverse arts community. The world is filled with conflicts and differences and challenges. And our capacity to lean on each other, to draw those stories together, to weave them into an extraordinary, overarching narrative that we can all see ourselves in, that's the challenge of the 21st century. And that's the challenge we don't meet unless all of you are at your very best. So that's why I want to start tonight by thanking you. Thank you to the people on stage and backstage. Thank you to the technicians who work long hours, the booking agents who take risks, the museum workers who dutifully preserve our history. You are doing outstanding work, but you are also doing essential work for all of us. Les deux dernières années ont été extrêmement difficiles. Comme Pablo vient juste de le dire, dès le début de la pandémie, on a mis sur pied le fonds d'urgence pour soutenir les organismes chargés de la culture. Ce fonds a permis à des milliers d'organismes de rester opérationnels. Récemment, j'ai rencontré un couple de deux musiciens classiques à Kitchener. Ian est contrebassiste et Allen était violoniste. Ils ont deux jeunes enfants. Leur orchestre n'a pas pu donner de concert pendant une partie de la pandémie, mais au moins, ils ont pu garder leur emploi grâce aux différents programmes de soutien comme la subvention salariale. Puis je ne veux pas réfléchir à comment on serait plus pauvre en tant que pays si on avait perdu pendant cette pandémie de nombreux contrebassistes et violonistes. Il fallait qu'on tienne bon. Et parce qu'on a tenu bon ensemble, ces deux sont contents de pouvoir recommencer à jouer leur instrument pour gagner leur vie, mais aussi pour reconnecter avec le public. Ils restent optimistes, mais ils vivent encore avec beaucoup d'incertitudes. Alors, cette semaine, le Sommet national sur la culture est l'occasion de continuer à travailler ensemble pour s'assurer que la relance soit forte et durable pour des gens comme Ian et Alain. Arts, culture, and heritage are also significant drivers of our economy. And as you know, I'm not only talking about ticket sales and revenues. When people go to see plays, concerts, or dance performances, that often involves getting dinner nearby or a visit to the boutique. On top of that, your contributions attract tourists from across the country and around the world. Everyone benefits it, so it's important that we continue to be here to support you. We know that many cultural workers are independent and self-employed. So in February, we launched the Performing Arts Workers Resilience Fund to provide targeted assistance to those who need it. Today, I can announce that four independent agencies will distribute $50 million directly to affected self-employed individuals in the sector. La Fondation des Artistes, the Actors Fund of Canada, the Canadian Dance Assembly, and the Unison Benevolent Fund will help us provide nationwide coverage to a range of artists and technicians. We'll have more to say soon, well, Pablo will have more to say soon on how we'll deliver support for professional development and mentoring, also through the Resilience Fund. Just as artists are significant economic drivers, you also drive important conversations. I was in Winnipeg a little over a week ago to attend a ceremony for the transfer of the historic Hudson's Bay building to the Southern Chiefs organization. The building will be renovated and repurposed, but it's vacant right now. So last year, partners in the community decided to use the window panels to do an installation that features artwork from Indigenous artists Peter Thomas and Glenn Gear. Projects like these help us see the world through each other's eyes. They help us understand one another. Que ce soit des pièces de théâtre documentaires qui parlent d'environnement ou des spectacles de spoken word qui traitent d'expériences vécues de discrimination, la culture nous fait réfléchir et elle nous fait évoluer. Maintenant, suite à la pandémie, avec les nouvelles technologies, vos secteurs changent rapidement, pas seulement ici, mais partout dans le monde. This week's summit is important because we have to continue working together to ensure long-term growth and competitiveness for your sectors. We want you to have the tools you need to win back audiences, adapt to new digital platforms, and be part of the conversation for a more open and inclusive society. So thank you for your participation. Our government will continue working with you as partners. Because we understand. I think, you know, here Pablo and I are going to pull the Quebecer card. But you're an élément d'identité de culture que nous, les Québécois, ont toujours compris, mais qu'on voit à travers le pays de plus en plus fort. In a globalized world, in a digital world, in a diverse world, it becomes so much more important to share and tell our stories. And the fact that new platforms allow us to play to such larger audiences everywhere around the world, it's an incredibly important opportunity, not just for Canadian artists to resonate around the world, but for the message that we have to share of what we've managed to develop here in this country by being open to one another. by not having to leave one culture behind to melt into a pot of a uniform culture, however unsuccessful that always ends up trying to be. But a country and an identity that is proud of the layers and textures and stories that are all piled in together and coexisting simultaneously. And it's as important to celebrate our successes, as it is, like come from away, as it is to look squarely at where we've faltered, where as a country we haven't lived up to the idea of Canada that we all carry in our minds. The story of residential schools and the need for more reconciliation being first and foremost around that. But there are so many layers of stories that need to be told. Stories that are distinctly Canadian, but universal in their application. And the way we are able to make sure that all of you and everyone, each of you, one of you here, represents in various ways, shapes, or forms, is able to find your strongest voice, is able to pierce through in a time of so much cynicism, of skepticism, of polarization in some ways, to reach out and grab that common humanity, those shared experiences that unite us, and that, yes, define us, even in all our differences. The role of the arts in making us think, in making us dream, in challenging us, yes, but also in defining ourselves for ourselves through our strong songs and our stories and every way we have to challenge and share. These are things that are becoming more and more important in a world in challenge and in a world in crisis. And I am And let me just finish on that note then, because you seem to like it. I am incredibly, incredibly privileged to be able to be the Prime Minister of Canadians at a time where all of you are stepping up, not just in this room, but across the country from coast to coast to coast, to build stronger communities, to build a better country, to build a better world. Merci, mes amis.